So how would you say that Liberian living in Liberia stay connected?
Well, you know, because we live in this society right now that has a lot of internet, so we stay in contact by communicating on the internet. We also call. Picking up the phone and calling home is really no big deal. So we talk to each other pretty much every day, virtually, you know, several times a day. So we stay connected really well, I guess.
And have you been back to Liberia since peace was established?
Yes, I did. I went back for the inauguration of the president, and, you know, I was able to interact with her. So it was a very moving experience to be able to go home after, you know, 17 years of being in the United States.
How would you say that Liberians contribute to the American society and culture?
Well, Liberians are very hardworking people. We come here and we see an opportunity and we attack that opportunity heads on. So we are hardworking, we're motivated, so we're not lazy people at all. So everything we do, we put our 110% towards it. So that's how we contribute.
And what are some things that you think that Liberians who are already living in the United States can do to help, you know, some of your brothers and sisters that are still there in the country?
Some of the things the Liberians in the United States can do is to raise funds, help the homeless, help single mothers, those that do not have families or friends, you know, raise funds, give them money to do business. If they need shelter, we build something that they can begin with, and you know, we can start from there. That would be a good beginning.
Okay, and just one more question. How do you see the role of women affecting Liberian culture, whether it's a positive or a negative way, here in America and also in Liberia?
The positive way, I believe people should go to school, Liberians should go to school to be educated, because education, I believe, is one of the things that make you equal with the rich. So when you go to school, you'll be able to generate funds, take care of your family, take care of your country, help your friends and those that are in need.
Because we're all over in different areas, I think that right there,
right,
sent to say where our strength is, that we are people that can adapt to any kind of situation given whatever the issue is. You know, that's something that we do well at.
And we love our passion. We're passionate about everything that we touch, everything that we are involved in. We're very passionate. So everywhere we go, we will make something of it. Whether it's in Philadelphia or all the way in Nevada, we're still, I mean, people still know that we're there and we're Liberians. And we're easily recognized because of all of our efforts and our passion.
Okay, and what, being that the country had just gone through a civil war, what would you say are some of the key elements to rebuilding the country so that it is going into the progressive mode, and you know,
the key element that I would think definitely would be a sense of unity and understanding that at the end of the day, Liberians are who we are, not our individual counties or locations where we're born. We're still Liberians, and people view us as Liberians, not, you know, you're from here, you're from there. So just that unity and bringing that together, not dividing ourselves, you know, not thinking that we're separate. That would definitely help to rebuild.